Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So we are continuing with the COMSOL series, and today I'll tell you how to derive an average property of any dependent variable from a simulation in COMSOL multiphysics. So before starting the discussion, let me tell you something about myself. I'm Shishanu Mitro, a research scholar of Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. And those are my email IDs. If you have any queries, you can write me email. So now let us proceed with the topic. So this is a simulation which I already simulated, and the simulation is done for a simple pipe flow. So I'll just brief you. So this is the laminar flow physics that has been taken, and this is the inlet for the flow, that is the outlet for flow. And water has been taken as a material, and I go to geometry to show you the dimension. So the height of the channel is 100 micrometer, and the length is 5 times of that, that is 500 micrometer. So this is a flow inside a micro channel, and the flow is driven by pressure, because I have taken 5 Pascal of pressure, 5 Pascal of gauge pressure at the inlet, and outlet is kept as 0 Pascal gauge pressure, that means the atmospheric pressure. So the reason of flow is pressure gradient across the along the channel. So now I'll show you the velocity profile after the simulation. The velocity profile whichever we got is like this. Now I want to actually plot the velocity, say along this line. So for that I have to take a line that is called cut line in COMSOL. So for that you go to result, just right click on it, and then click on 1D plot group, and again right click on 1D plot group, and then click on line graph. So one line graph has been added. Now this line graph is taken to plot the particular variable. Now for plotting you need a data set, and for the data set you go to data set and right click on it, and then click on cut line 2D. Now in cut line 2D you can define the coordinates and you can draw the line. Now I want to have a line along this. So this is your x equal to 250 micrometer, and y would be varying from 0 to 100 micrometer. So y is varying from 0 to 100 micrometer. So I write 0 to 100, and your x is constant, that is 250. So if I plot it, I'll get the cut line. Now this cut line would take the data from study one solution one means the very solution which we have. Now I go to 1D plot group 3. So here I take the data from cut line 2D and select the time as last. Now the thing is, here I am taking the data set from cut line 2D. Again, cut line 2D is taking the data set from the study. So automatically I am taking the data set for 1D plot group from this study. So in line graph we have already taken SPF.U, that is the x directional velocity. After plotting you get this profile. Now this is the velocity profile, you all know, but I want to calculate the average velocity along this line. Along this line means along the cut line which we have already taken. So this is the cut line. Now for that you have an option here in COMSOL that is called derived values. You just right click on the derived values, then you will get an option called average. Now in average you will have 3 more options, and those are volume average, surface average and line average. From the diagram itself you can understand we are going to calculate line average. So we click on line average. Now you need to calculate average of some property. So you need to define that property. Before that, you need to define the data set. Now the data set would come from the cut line 2D1. Now I want to calculate, say, average velocity for the last time step, and your expression is spf.u, because I am calculating the average velocity and velocity is given by u. Now if you ask me, how do you know that capital U is the average, I mean the velocity along x direction? To know that, you can go to laminar flow and you can check there dependent variable. There is an option called dependent variable. If you go there, you can see u is the average velocity, u is the x directional velocity, v is the y directional, and w is the z directional. That is why we are taking u. So again I go to derived values from that line average. Now if I just click on evaluate, it will calculate the average velocity. So you can see here the average velocity is coming somewhere 0.0083. Now if I show you the velocity profile here, you can see from here the maximum value is 0.012. Now you all know the average velocity is around half of the maximum velocity, but here it is not coming exactly half because this is the line average. But when you do the average velocity for a pipe flow, then you take the average over the circular cross section, but here we are not taking any circular cross section, that is why it is not matching. What I mean to say is that it should come around 0.006, because the maximum velocity is around 0.012, but it is coming 0.008, and the reason behind is I'm not taking average over the circular cross section for a pipe, but I am taking average or mean of the velocity along a straight line. That is why this is not matching. But the thing is, for your concept purpose or for the purposes of learning, I am just showing you, but never never mix it with the original average velocity. So I'll make a separate video on that regard. Okay, so one more thing I need to tell you. Suppose now I want to calculate average of some other property. So what shall I do? I go here and click on it. Suppose I want to have average property of pressure. So I click on pressure, then I plot it. So you can see the pressure is varying like this along the channel. Now I want the average of pressure. So for that, again here I click on pressure and then click on evaluate. Before clicking, you should delete the previous value. Now I click on evaluate. So you can see the average pressure is showing somewhere 2.4749. So whatever property you are looking for, you can change it from here and you can have the average velocity. Now suppose I want to calculate average over an area. So what shall I do? I go to derived value, right click on it, again go to average and then select surface average. Now I can choose the surface. Say this is the surface. I want to calculate the average velocity over this entire surface, that is the area average. So I choose, area is already chosen, so I choose last time step and then delete the previous value and click on evaluate. So I get, this is the average over the entire area. it is also safe, but that is not the issue. The issue is how do you calculate the area average, line average, and the volume average. The volume average is not possible here in this case because you have taken a 2D geometry. In 2D you cannot have any average volume average property, because the volume is itself zero because you have only two dimensions. So I guess things are clear now. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.